school, he made many prayers, especially be dutiful to those whom you have mutual rights. Indeed, God is all watching. For believers, have conscious awareness of God, speak nothing but truth, so he can rectify your deeds, he can forgive your sins. Best among you who follow God Almighty's command and method of Muhammad, peace and blessing upon him. For today's khutbah, I have chosen a verse from Surah Al-Baqarah, chapter 2, verse 183. For believers, fasting is prescribed mandatory for you the way it was for previous people, so you can become righteous. So inshallah, in context of that verse, I will briefly talk about the ultimate aspect, ultimate goal of fasting, because it was prescribed for previous people, people of book, Jewish, Christians, they do fast. So it is prescribed for us, that's what the verse says, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ, so you can become righteous. So we have to focus what's the ultimate thing, why the fasting is prescribed, what is the ultimate goal from God Almighty, and that is for us to attain taqwa, righteousness, and get closer to God, have a submission and complete, utter submission to God Almighty alone. So briefly I'll talk about the things that I have to do. It's a reminder for myself and all of us, action items for this month of Ramadan. That we have to have some action items, the things that we have to do. At least I have to do, as a reminder for myself, the first, and then all of us. Because fasting is completely, utterly between myself and God Almighty, because you don't know I'm fasting or not, and I don't know you're fasting or not. Because this is complete self-control, self-restraint, submission to God Almighty, feeling for other people, thinking about it, pondering about it, why are you doing it just for God Almighty alone? And that's why God Almighty says this hadith, As-sawmu li wa la ajzi bihi. This is just completely, utterly for me, so therefore I'm the one who personally gonna reward for it, which means only God knows what's the reward for it. So that's why we need to focus. We have heard this many times, but today it's gonna focus on what are the things that we need to at least during month of Ramadan get those done, or at least some sort of checklist. So word Ramadan, I thought maybe this is the best way to remember for all of us. Ramadan in English, R-A-M-A-D-A-N. So I'm going to go through those letters. R, reflect. Reflect, why are you here? What are you doing? What's the purpose? What's the reasoning? Why? The why question should come in our heart and mind. And there got to be reason why I'm here in this particular situation, particular time. Could have been somewhere else. We are here. There's a reason for it. Why? Reflect. What is the reason? What's the purpose? Why God created you? And that's R. A, act upon what you already know. We all know what's right, what's wrong. We all know not cheating, backbiting, slander, defame. We need to have various common cause, common good, stand up for justice, peace, equality, harmony. So act upon what we already know. M, minimize waste. We have so much waste, so much wealth being wasted, so much talent being wasted, so much food in month of Ramadan being wasted. When Muslims supposed to fast from dawn to dusk, I believe somewhere it's going to be closer to 4:20, 4:30, and then finish around 8. So imagine how many hours are there. 16 hours we go without water, without drink, without smoke, without anything inhaling, none whatsoever, just natural air, right? We control, self-control, self-restraint. Despite of that, a lot of food being wasted at the time of iftar. A, we have to abstain from judging others. We can't make judgment call only. God Almighty knows who's going to go to heaven, who's going to go to hell, who's going to accept, who's not going to accept. That's not my job, that's not your job. That was specifically said many times in the Quran from Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam that you are not a guardian over them. You just convey the message and leave it up to them. It's a matter between me and him, me and them. That's what Quran says over and over. So R-A-M-A-D, devote your time to the book, the Quran. That's the ultimate book for us. Yes, as a Muslim, we do believe in Bible. We do believe in Torah, Gospels. But the ultimate book for us, the final book is the Quran. That is the mezan. That's the final scale. That's the final ultimate test. So read and memorize, understand, ponder, think. What is that? And devote time to this book. Understand that book. This is the only miracle of any prophet today that is well and alive with us, is the Quran.
And it will be well protected in the day of judgment because God Himself said, نَحْنُ نَزَلْنَا ذِكْرَ وَإِنَّ لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ I'm the one who is in control and custody of this message and I will protect and preserve. And Allah has preserved it. A-D-A. Avoid trampling upon other people's rights. Watch out. Yes, these people, Christian, atheist, agnostic, doesn't matter what faith or religion, be very careful. The people, your interaction with people can lead you in hellfire, can lead you in heaven. So that is something that ultimately we have to keep in mind. In the last end, no one will go in heaven except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy alone. So if you go through the Ramadan, reflect, A, act, M, minimize the wastage and the damage in essence as well, because you're wasting food, you'll be responsible for that. And A, abstain from judging others. D, devote time to the Quran, to the book. A, avoid trampling upon other people's right. Hakukul ibad, focus on that. And N, no one will go to Jannah except Allah's mercy. So let's inshallah briefly go through those. Reflection. Why? What's the purpose? Why am I here? I'm here to just, you know, come, eat, drink, marry, have kids, get a job, trample upon people's right, make a lot of wealth, money, doesn't matter how I attain it, and then die, get buried. Why? What's the difference between myself and other animals? We are social animals, but what is the purpose? Social, yes. So we have to socialize, we have to interact, we have to get involved. Why? Why Allah created me in this shape, in this form, in this language, this culture, this society, this mosque, this neighborhood? Why? He could have placed me somewhere in the desert. He could have placed me somewhere in the middle of the ocean. Could have been fish. But for him, a human being, the God to be something. Ahsan taqweem. He created in the best manner, best shape. Look at yourself, stand in front of a mirror. فَفِي أَنفُسِكُمْ أَفَلَا تُبْصِرُونَ Why don't you look at your own body and ponder? Think about it. Why? Who are you? Stand just in front of the mirror. Look at your eyes. Look at your face. How beautiful. If the eye is somewhere up here or somewhere down here, would you look good? And Allah is God that al-Mutlaq. He could have created you that way. How? Look at two eyes, two nostrils, two ears, one mouth. Which means what? Take in twice, observe twice, listen twice. When it comes to speaking, speak only once. Make sure your ratio is only once. Why? مَا يَلْفِزُ مِنْ قَوْلٍ إِلَّا لَدَيْهِ رَكِيبٌ عَتِيدٌ Surah Qaf, Surah number 50, verse number 18. Not a single word that you utter, it's not being recorded. But observation is different. Pondering is different. أَفَلَا يَتَّقْبَرُونَ الْقُرْآنِ When are you going to ponder? When are you going to think? Yes, instant courage. Question, yes, question. Question who you are, where you are, why you are, who created you. Yes, that question is encouraged in our deen. Because that question will bring back to God Almighty. There is a God. There is a Supreme Being. Yes, the injustice is happening in this world right now, in the past week or so. No person can compensate for injustice. If we catch Hitler today, what are we going to do to him? Give him what? Death sentence? Punish him? So what? But one life, one. What happened to millions of others that he has destroyed? So therefore leads me to somewhere that there got to be somebody who is al-adil, who is just, who will have a final day of reckoning, Yawm al-Deen. He is the one who will have a just day, and that's the day that I'm looking forward to. So I don't want to be embarrassed, I want to stand in front of him. Reflect, ponder, ultimate questioning. Quran is full of yasalunaka, yasalunaka, yasalunaka. Oh Muhammad, they're asking you, oh Muhammad, they're asking you this, they're asking you this. Ask question, because if you honestly ask question and look honestly answer in the Quran, you'll bring back to God Almighty alone. He's the one who's the Qadir al-Mutlaq. Think about, ponder. You don't know what my weakness is, you know your weakness. I don't know yours, you don't know mine. بَلِ الْإِنسَانُ عَلَىٰ نَفْسِ بَصِيرًا Everybody knows their own internal capability. You know your weakness, you know your strength. Work on your weakness. Work your weakness and do not show off about your strength. This is what we need to do. We need to minimize our desires. desires within our means, because these desires lead us to wrong path. I'm making only $100 in one day, but I have to pay a mortgage, $110. Guess what? Where is the 10 going to come? It will be forcing me to cheat, lie, backbite, steal, do something wrong to maintain it. But if I have the building, the children, and the relationship with the family and spouse, she will say, the children will say, it doesn't matter. We want to live within our means. We don't have to show off to have a big house. Because auntie has big house, uncle has big house, we want to have a big house. And that forcing us to do wrong thing. If we live within our means, life will be much better and easy and content. And that's something we need to do. We need to focus. We do not. And we go overboard and we push ourselves. We need to minimize desire. What the Quran say? Am lil insan am ma tamanna. Whatever you desire, do you think you'll get everything? You don't. You won't. So therefore, reflect what Allah has given you. Alhamdulillah. Allah didn't give it to you. Alhamdulillah. Because there's a reason for it. He didn't give it to you. But look back at your class fellows, those who are adult here. He had a lot of class fellows, those who were much better, much smarter, much better resources back in the country that you're coming from. They're hand to mouth. And Allah has blessed you. You're playing with dollars. You're playing with the currency. You're playing with the enjoyable life. You have a nice drinking water at least. There are so many countries that we come, you don't have any water. So you're blessed. Think about it. Ponder. Unzur kayfa kasabu ala anfusihim. Think about how they're lying about themselves. We live in a bubble. We make our life so hard and miserable, and then we lie and lie and build and build and build, and we come to the point that we lose the dunya. We never made the ultimate design, and then we die in debt, and we never made akhirah. So reflect, ponder, think about this month. That Allah wants you hungry, thirsty. Why? It does not need hunger, thirst. You want to have a self-control, self-restraint, think, control. That's what we need to do, reflect. Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, what a beautiful saying. He said, Ajabu li hazal insan. What a centric, what a unique human being. A human being is what? What a unique human being. Yanzu bi sha'min, yatakallamu bi lahmin. Think about what he's saying. This is the pondering that we need to require. That what yasma bi azamin yatanaffasu bi kharamin. What a centric, unique human being that he sees through a clot of blood. He sees through what? Clot of blood. Look at eyes. Somebody take the eye out, what is that? Clot of blood. Through fat. Yatakallamu bi lahmin, he speaks with what? Blood, you know, with the lahm, with meat. Hold your tongue and try to speak. You can't. Hold it, you won't be able to say. This lahm, this meat makes you talk. Yasma'u bi'azamin, listens through the hollow skull. Listening through this, right? What is the whole thing? Skull. Yatanaffazu bi'kharmin, is breathe through a pipe. You can have billions of pipe. You can have billions of pound of meat. You can have billions of skull or hollow skulls. Ask them to speak. Ask them to reflect. Can't. But Allah has made us in a way. A small thing. What happened if I lose my voice right now? Look beautiful, tall, right? Nothing. I can't communicate. I can even ask for water. I have to go through hand and gesture and learn. What a blessing. What a blessing. So this is the reflection that we have to do. Act upon what you already know. Then the second point, we don't have much time. Act. We already know what's halal and what's haram. We already know what's easy and what's hard. We already know what can take us to heaven and what can take us to hell. We already know not to lie, not to cheat, not to backbite, not to do slander, bohtan, defame, defamation. We already know respect elderly, respect your family, respect your friends, respect your spouse, respect your neighbor, respect your teacher. We already know what's right and wrong. Act upon it. Act upon it. That's what Allah wants us to do. Ahsana amala. That's what Allah wants. Allazi khalaqa al-mauta wal-hayata liyabluwakum ayyukum ahsana amala. He has created a life and death cycle to check us what? Ahsana amala. Give your best shot. Best shot in what you know. Allah will not ask us that you could have been graduated from Al-Azhar, you could have a master PhD, muhaddas, mu'allam, mufassir. No, Allah will ask what you did with your own capacity. With your own capacity. So that's something we need to all think about. Inna sama wal basara wal fawad. Allah will ask, Surah number 17, verse number 36, that how did you use your eyesight? How did you use your ears? How did you use your wisdom? We use this for everything else, but when it comes to our deen and our relationship with the other human being, we'll completely ask him and ask her, she knows. No, you know. Balil insan wala nafsi basira. You know about yourself, what's your weakness, you know how to interact with other. When it comes to dunya and benefit, we bargain to the best of ability. When it comes to akhira, well, you know, ask him or her, she knows. So act upon what you already know. R-A-M. Minimize waste. With tons of food being wasted in the month of Ramadan. A non-Muslim friend, they say, when is your Ramadan? I say, why? Because we have such a lavish iftars. Tons of food, man. I'm going to come and join you. That's the culture we want to teach our children. Ramadan comes, we're going to have hanawalas, pakoras, samosa, all this and that. And then we compete. She had 10 dishes for iftar, I'm going to have 20. Their biryani, I'm going to have this. Why is that the logic? Logic is other way around. Self-control, self-restraint, and feel for other those who don't have food. You are blessed. After 16 hours, you're going to have food. There are tons of people. In this country, there are more than 38 million children that sleep hungry. 38 million. You love your child. But according to Islam, every child is my child and your child. 38 million plus sleep hungry. Sit down with your family, say, children, spouse, what's our budget for week? For grocery, $300. Well, guess what? Sometimes we eat suhoor, sometimes we don't. But we're not going to eat at least lunch, right, Ramadan? We're not going to have snack time, Ramadan. So guess what? One third of our food is going to get cut. But from my pocket, $300 goes for grocery. I'm going to keep on funding $300. But what are we going to do? We're going to have a box in our garage next to our door. Before we leave house, we're going to put our lunch money in that box. I'm going to box right next to my desk where I work each time before I sit on my chair. Allah has given me this chair as a blessing, as an honor, as a professor, as a doctor, as an engineer, as a cab driver. Allah has blessed me with this ability. I'm going to, before I sit on that seat, I'm going to put sadaqah. $1, $2, 50 cents. And after 30 days, I'm going to empty this box and I'm going to share with children and say, listen, let's go to masjid and we'll give to charity. God, there are tons of charities, tons of people hungry. $100 from your pocket is going to go anyway. Let it make worth here and hereafter. What Quran says, "Kulu washrabu wa la tusrafu. Inna Allah la yuhibbul musrifin." Drink, eat, enjoy, but don't waste, because Allah does not like the people those who waste. And that's what we do. I have people in the month of Ramadan, they gain weight. How? 16 hours, you're hungry, thirsty. In order to get away, because you loaded yourself. And you loaded to the point that you can't eat anymore, you can't even pray anymore, and the rest of it goes in trash. Honey, I need a fresh one tomorrow. Do you know you'll be asked for this? There are so many people who don't have this. And Allah has given to you, reflect upon you. Why He's given to you? To check you out. And Allah gives some and checks. Allah takes away from some and checks. R-A-M-A. Abstain from judging others. It's not my job. I'm worried about myself. With Allah's mercy, inshallah, I'll make it to Jannah. I don't know about myself. How can I make judgment call? You're going to go to Jahannam, she's going to go to Jahannam. Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar! How? How? This is something we have to be very careful. We make so much judgment calls. So many, based on culture, based on language. By the time somebody finishes Salat, yeah, he's Gharamukullah, he's Wahhabi, he's Egyptian, he's Saudi, he's Hanfi, he's Maliki. Allahu Akbar! Was all this there when Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Sallu kama ra'aytumuni yusalli? Pray the way I pray. Was Egyptian there? Was Hanfi, Maliki, humbly there? May Allah give Jannatul Firdaus those who passed away. Those who are alive, may Allah guide us all. Those who are coming, may Allah make sadaqah jariyah. We have no beef with anybody. But we have a beef when you play as a God. Only God knows who's going to go to heaven, who's going to go to hell. And we have a reflection from the nation of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. The lady who is what? I can't even mention what she was doing. And she just fed a thirsty cat. In one narration, thirsty dog. And Allah said, you're going to heaven. And the khatib, the alam, the martyr who gave his life in path of Allah, Allah said, you're going to Jahannam and hellfire. So what? Look at these people, they know me, I gave up my life. Yes, I know. Inna Allah alimu bi zaati sudur. I know your heart. Your heart beat, I know. But in dunya, you did this to show people off. Yes, I know the Quran. Yes, I fight in the path of God. Yes, I'm the leader. And these people say, yeah, mashallah, brother did good. And you got that fame. Today is Yawm al-Deen. Day of exchange. And I know what to exchange because innama al-amalu bin-niyyat. Every deed counts based on your intention. Intention was dunya and fame, you got it. Today is my day and I'm going to tell you, that's what you get. Because you didn't do it for me. This was what? Martyr Shaheed. This is who? Alim al-Quran. Who? One who gave the share to the masjid. It's a narration. Think about it. And the one who gave water to the thirsty cat, the thirsty dog. What she was doing, I can't even mention. Where she was going, what she was playing was, what she used to do. Allah said, you're going to Jannah. So brother, stop. Sister, stop judging. Worry about yourself. Be prepared. Let this ego go. I am the battle. I'm the doctor, I'm the professor, I'm the engineer. No. I has to go. I has to go. There is no I. It's we. We're all together. I is from shaitan. Ana min al-nar. Huwa min al-teen. I'm from the fire. I am the fire. He's from clay. This ego gotta go. When I die, there's no I. You're gonna give me shawar. Right now I gotta look nice, awesome, mashallah, right? How many of you have a heart attack right now? All is up to you. This thing gonna get ripped off. You're gonna give me shawar? Am I ready? Am I prepared to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Am I ready to hand over my body to you? Think about it. This is what the month of Ramadan, reflection. Prayer all day long, I know. Prayers are good. Please, can you move up? Zakallah khair. Prayers are good, but they're ritual to get to underline the message of Rahmah, the kindness, pleasure, and closeness to God. So that's what we need to do. R-A-M-A. Devote your time, D. Devote your time to Quran. This is the only book United Muslim during Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam time, United Muslim during the scientific revolution and renaissance, because Abu Ali Sina was half as a Quran. Lot of other scientists were half as a Quran. This is the only miracle of any prophet which is well and alive today, is Quran. Devote your time to Quran. Why month of Ramadan is so important? Why? Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was born in Rabiul Awwal. Rabiul Awwal should be awesome, right? It is in different meaning. But why month of Ramadan is so important? Shahr Ramadan al-lazi unzila fihi al-Quran. This is the month of Quran came. Love your book. Understand it. Ponder upon it. Ask the hafiz you're going to recite from Alif Lam to Nas. Brother, what are you going to recite tomorrow? Which ayah to which ayah? Put a CD. I can assure you, you spend 37 minutes a day. You'll finish entire Quran in month of Ramadan. 37. Go check. Your job is more than 37 minutes away. Going and coming back. 37 minutes you'll finish entire Quran. Try to understand. Afala yatadabbaruna Quran. Ponder, think what this book says, what it's talking about. It's talking to me when it says, Ya ayyuhal lazina amanu. Replace the amanu. Say, Ya ayyuhal lazina ajaz. Ya ayyuhal lazina fatima. Ya ayyuhal lazina ali. Oh Ali. Oh Fatima. Oh ajaz. Oh Ismail. What are you doing? Quran is talking to me. Quran says that we do your tazkira, we do your zikr, you don't even know. So this is what we need to do. A. Avoid trampling upon other people's rights. We gotta watch out. This is my Jannah. This is my Jahannam. People, Allah will forgive. It's Ghafoor Rahim. People don't forgive. For ages, for centuries, for generation after generation, people will not forgive. Well, he didn't do this to me. He didn't do. You know what? You guys are not going to go to his house. We're not going to go to him. People will never forgive. Allah will forgive. Therefore, my interaction with people, I mentioned last khutbah, my interaction with people can lead me to Jannah, hopefully inshallah, but it will definitely hinder me to get to Jannah. Because Prophet ﷺ said, إِنَّ الْمُفْلِسَ فِي أُمَّتِي يَأْتِي يَوْمَ الْقَيَامَةِ بِسَلَاةٍ بِزَكَاةٍ بِسَيَامٍ. Loaded with Ramadan, loaded with Zakat, and loaded with what? Salat. But what happened? فَتُورِيَ فِي النَّارِ. Why? وَيُقْ فَيُوتِيَ سَلَاتُهُ. Given his charity. Why? Because his interaction was not good. So be careful. This is your Jannah. And Jannah, the Hadith says, your neighbor is hungry, you're not a moment. Neighbor doesn't have to be Muslim or Muqallad or Egyptian or Pakistani or Mufassir or you know Maliki or Hanfi. No, no, no. It just says neighbor. Atheist, agnostic, Jewish, doesn't matter. Sleeps hungry and you have a food, tough luck, buddy. That's what our deen tells us. So focus on that. This is our Jannah. This dunya is our Jannah, our interaction. You walk through your Jannah's door every day in and out when you say salam, when you say, hey, hi buddy, how are you? When you open the door for somebody, thank you. That's your interaction, does count. The last thing, nobody will go to Jannah except Allah's mercy. When it comes to that ultimate thing, you did psalm, salat, zakat, ponder upon it, memorize the Quran, reflected it, acted on it, you stop judging other people, you have better treatment of others. Be careful. Still not enough. Because enough is what Allah's mercy. Qalu ya Rasulullah wa ant. What about you, O Nabi? Think about the Sahabi who had that much guts to ask Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ya Rasulullah, what about you? Say, wa la ana illa yataghammadani Allahu minhu bi rahmah. Yes, indeed, for me also Allah's mercy will take me to Jannah. This is Muhammad who's walking, talking Quran. Wa man yuti Rasul faqad ataa Allah. قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُوا يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. This is walking, talking Muhammad Quran, who has seen the Jannah and heaven and hell while he was alive. He himself said, وَأَنَا يَتَغَمَدْنِيَ اللَّهُ until Allah's mercy. So which means what? The ultimate criteria is mercy, kindness, be respectful to each other. Have mercy, have feeling about each other. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us wisdom, vision, strength, that do we reap the benefit of these tasks, the goals that I have, you know, shared with you. May Allah give us wisdom that we reboot from this 30 days camp and we can be, have energy to go on for another 11 months and reboot inshallah next Ramadan. May Allah give us wisdom, vision, strength to understand His deen and implement upon ourselves and then convey to others with hikmah. Ameen, summa, ameen, in the law of إن الله ملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين خاتم النبيين رحمة العالمين وعلى آله الطاهرين. أما بعد ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا أظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. اللهم إنا نسألك من الخير كله ونعوذ بك من شر كله. آمين ثم آمين يا رب العالمين. أقم الصلاة.
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين ولا إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواسوا بالحق وتواسوا بالصبر الله سمع الله لمن حمده الله الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله الله أكبر الله الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله أستغفر الله السلام عليكم
الأشخاص بالتسويق.